In this second video of my five-part series, I'm going to give you five tips for filming with your phone. What's good, everyone? My name is Philip Lemoyne, and I'm actually a full-time cinematographer, but I love to cook. On this channel, I'm not only posting cooking videos with some of my favorite tried and true recipes, but I also share tips and strategies to help you make your own cooking videos. So if you're hungry for great tasting food or that YouTube money, spank that subscribe button. This section of the five-part video series can get pretty in-depth, going over exactly how to film every second of video footage. In this video tutorial, I'm gonna give you five tips for video production to help you capture the best looking video and audio for your cooking channel content. I'll also explain how to shoot efficiently so that way you're not spending hours sifting through footage when it's time to edit your videos. So tip number one is setting the stage for your video. So the first step to good looking videos is going to be setting up your camera or phone to figure out what's going to be in your frame. Take a second to figure out where you're planning to stand. I would recommend not standing directly in front of a wall. It creates a flat image and it casts your shadow on the wall behind you. Put some space between you and the background to give your video some depth. Take a second to set your phone up and point it in the direction that you plan on filming and look around your image and see what's in your frame. What's in the background? What's in the foreground? Is there a window that makes it really bright behind you? Is there a mess or any distractions? Take some time to clean up your space to your liking by removing any of the unwanted items that you have in your frame shot. You can also add things in your frames like flowers or decorations as well. Or you can just leave it how you want it and don't change a thing at all. Do whatever makes you happy and it's your video. Once you have your background figured out, the next thing you're gonna wanna do is set up your lighting. Check out my other video that I created that breaks down the different lighting techniques. Once you position your lights to your liking, we can move on to the next tip. So tip number two is to figure out your composition. I personally try and follow the rule of thirds. Imagine two lines running across your frame, vertically and horizontally. You can stand off to one third of your frame with the two thirds of space on the other side. I normally place myself in the center of the camera frame with my eyes on the top third of the frame, leaving myself with a little bit of headroom. You don't want to cut the top of your head off, but you also don't want to give yourself way too much headroom. You also want to try and fill your frame with the thing that you're emphasizing the most important in the shot. A wide shot is fine, but it can sometimes get distracting to the viewer because they have a lot to look at. If you fill the frame, they know what they need to focus on. The third tip is going to be selecting the right camera on your phone and your settings. For this video, I'll be using an iPhone 11, but if you have a different phone, the camera quality and settings should be pretty similar. You'll just need to find out where the settings are on the phone. Normally, the main camera on the back is the best on most phones, but the selfie camera is okay to use as well. The iPhone front selfie camera is still pretty good because they shoot in 4K Ultra HD. And if you choose a selfie camera, avoid looking at yourself on the screen. Look at the camera area. It's like making eye contact with the person that's watching your video. If you plan to use a selfie camera when talking to your viewers, put something like a little piece of tape near that camera so that you can look at the tape because it is difficult to look at that tiny little lens. I personally plan to use my main camera on the back of my phone. So now that we know which camera that we're going to use, now we can adjust our settings. In the camera settings, there are different options for recording video. Select 4K if your phone has that option. This is the highest resolution my phone can shoot, and it's the best image quality. I'm gonna go with 4K at 60 frames per second. Once your settings are selected, do a test shot and record a clip first to check your framing, lighting, and audio. I'll go back and watch that video to make sure it looks and sounds how I like it.
What's good, everyone? My name is Philip, and on this channel, I post.
Before you begin shooting, it's also a good idea to set your phone on airplane mode to avoid any notifications that can interrupt your video shoot. One last important thing is to check if you have enough memory on your phone or external memory card if your phone has one before you begin filming. Once it's good to go, we can start filming the content. Tip number four is to shoot your entire talking part first. The first thing I like to do is shoot my entire script. I'll do all of my talking that I plan to do on camera, as well as read my entire script for the parts that I know will be a voiceover and be covered up with shots of me cooking. If you're interested in how I structure and write my scripts, I created a whole nother video on this topic and I'll put a link in the description once it's up. Take your time and go through each of your steps. If you stumble up on your words, it's okay. Just pause for a second, smile at the camera, and pick up from the last sentence back in your script. What's good, everyone? If this is the first time we're meeting, my name is Philip Lemoyne, and I'm actually a full-time cinematographer, but I love to cook. Try to shoot your entire script in one long take if possible, including your outro and call to action and the end as well. This makes it easy when it comes time to edit. This one long video clip is going to be the main shot of your video, and it's going to be called the A-roll. So tip number 5 is going to be to capture a lot of B-roll. B-roll is the footage or short clips that we'll be placing over your A-roll. It's good to get B-roll or cutaway shots of the things that you're going to be talking about in your script. Layering these shots over your A-roll makes for a more entertaining video for your viewer because they're not just watching you talk to the camera and they can actually see what you're talking about. B-roll are the things like shots of your individual ingredients, shots of you preparing these ingredients if you're explaining this process in your script, shots of you cooking, shots of you plating the dish, and final shots of the finished dish. One huge tip I would recommend for this step of filming your B-roll is to just shoot short 10 to 30 second clips of these steps you'd like to feature or show. Running long 2 to 5 minute shots of each step not only wastes a lot of memory on your camera or on your phone, but it'll also take way more time to sift through that footage just to find that short 3 to 5 seconds that you plan on using. Just shoot what you need. If you're doing something repetitive like peeling potatoes, you don't need to film yourself peeling all 10 potatoes. I call it shoot to edit. I also encourage you to get creative with your B-roll. Switching up your camera angles create a more dynamic video. So now that we have all of our content shot, but before we can eat, you'll want to make sure to get a great thumbnail photo. In the next video in this series, I'll break down how to shoot and design a thumbnail on your phone that will help attract more people to watch your videos. If you want to check out the entire video I shot on my phone, I'll be sure to put a link in the description or I'll have a card pop up over here. If you'd like to dive deeper into how I produce my cooking videos and how you can do it with your phone, make sure you check out my full in-depth cooking course. I'll be sure to put a link in the description once it's ready. I hope that you guys found value in this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a like and also check out my Facebook group, YouTube Cooking Creators. I'll put a link in the description. We're a community of YouTube cooks sharing our experience with hopes to grow our channels and make income with our cooking videos. Let me know if you had any questions in the comments below, and I'd love to share all the information and knowledge I have to help you make better looking cooking videos and grow your YouTube channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. I have a ton of other videos up and in the works to help you create better YouTube cooking content along with more great tasting recipe videos. If you want to catch those when they drop, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And thank you so much again for watching. Aloha.